What's going on, everybody? My name is Smoke, this is 563 Gaming, and welcome back to Subnautica! So, yeah, I told you in the last episode that I was going to be going around and collecting a bunch of stuff. Wow. That's pretty. And collect stuff I did. And I managed to get the blueprint for a solar panel, as well as the blueprint for the sea glide, which is some sort of underwater transportation. So, we need to make a couple different things. First of which, we need to make the mobile vehicle bay, so that we can make the mobile, you know, the sea glide. I think that's how it works. Either way, I've got the materials to make both of these. I just have to make the batteries. So, okay, I think I needed copper wire too, didn't I? Yes. Give me the copper wire. Okay. So, open this bad boy up. I need all of these. And okay, yeah, I put some of the copper down in the storage container in the other base. So let's go here. Yeah, I need the copper. Okay, easy enough. Let's go. Which way is... I think it's this way. Indeed it is. What I find interesting about this is... it says we have no power in here. But the lights are on. Alright. Grab copper, and we're gonna need that. I don't remember what I grabbed these for, but I'm gonna take them anyway. So let's pop back out. Resources, electronics, battery. Alright, now if I remember correctly, I needed a power cell for this and a battery for that. We can make the sea glide. Sweet. I didn't know that went into my inventory, but okay. Wow, it takes up a lot of inventory room. Okay. Whatever. It'll be useful. So, yes. So now we need to make... Is it in here? Please let it be in here. It's not. Well, I guess we're gonna test out the sea glide, aren't we? Alright, is it over this way? Oh, that's nice. Oh, that's very nice. That's going to make exploration a lot quicker. Okay, so I need the silicone rubber. Back out we go. Oh, wait. While we're here, now that the sun's up, before we go back over and make the mobile vehicle bay, let's go ahead and... Oh. Wrong thing. Bloop, bloop. Okay. Nope. Keep hitting the wrong mouse button. Okay. Let's make a solar panel. Alright, I want to leave enough room so I can put another one down. Awesome.
Power restored, Captain. All primary systems online.
Cool. So power's going up. I've got oxygen. Good to go. I'll probably have to make a couple more of those solar panels to get this thing, you know, fully operational to where we can actually do stuff with it, but good to know. All right, cool. I keep doing that. All right. Just grabbed a Sea Glide. Just because this thing's neat. This is going to make getting back and forth a breeze. And it gives you topographical information, so, you know, you can kind of get an idea of what's coming. Alright, so we need... deployables... What? Did I not make... Oh, that's right. Power cell. Okay. And... lubricant. No. Deployables. Okay. Let's go out here. And let's go ahead and assign that to that. Oh. I don't want to release it in that direction. We'll release it over here. Okay, cool. So... I'm not sure what this does yet. Okay. Why am I... Oh. Oh, it's got a light function on it too, huh? That's cool. Awesome. So, we've got that going for us. We got the Sea Glide, which I'm sure I'm going to have to put a battery in it every so often. So, you know, we'll have to keep mining copper, and I mean, there's tons of acid mushrooms around, so we're not lacking in that. And then copper is probably a pretty easy material to get as well. So, all right, let's go. Yeah, we're gonna go this way. Just test this bad boy out. Through the creepy creep vines. Yeah, I had one of those take a bite out of me earlier. It was not fun. So yeah, there's another one there. Another one over there. There's all kinds of them bad boys over here. Oh, we need to go up. Ooh. Of course, he's right there. Hold on, let me. Yeah. From what I've seen, these guys tend to stay down there towards the bottom. Dig in the sand, pop out, take a bite out of you. There's like, looks like some sort of hull piece or something over there. I want to go. Oh! Punks. Back off. Ugh. Sheesh.
30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
I gotta get out of here. I'm gonna get eaten. Oh, that was too close for comfort. But I got a sea moth fragment. Wow, them things hurt. Like little piranhas. Whew. Give me that. All right. That hurt. So, okay. That is definitely a dangerous area. I need like a spear gun to go in there or something. Sheesh. Do they even have one? Laser cutter, welder, nope. Okay. Current generator uses artificial gravity to generate convection current. Okay. Okay, so I have to wonder. All right, so we got one sea moth fragment over there. Let's head over to the base real quick. See how much power is generated. Ooh. Let me get this quartz real quick. This is not the best spot for a base, because this is the direction of the Aurora crash, and the further in they go this way, the more radiation there is. So we usually tend to head in that direction. Because as you can see, let me pop up real quick. Yeah, until we get a radiation suit, we really can't go much further beyond where the horizon is down here right now.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Yes. Thank you. All right. So we got Did I not get the whole sea moth fragment? I guess not. I got the heck out of there. So let's see. I need 2 more titanium to make another solar panel. Alright. Well, we got pretty good power going. What do I need to make a fabricator? Two titanium. Alright, we said we were going to come off on the corners, so the centerpieces are fine. Let's go ahead and plop in fabricator there. And now, we can craft in here. We can stop relying so much on the life pod. And I need 5 titanium and 5 quartz to make that thingy. Got 3 titanium. I can go out and get some real quick. There you go. Always do. Whoa. Frame drop. I need quartz too, so. Nighttime approaches. Some more quartz over here. Oh, there's a stalker right there. And yep, need a little bit of you. Yep. This should be all the titanium I need, but I do need some more copper too. And I need the quartz. Alright. I believe. Ooh, get up. I don't even think I have enough room. Take another piece of metal. I do. I have just enough room for another piece of metal salvage. And another quartz. Let's grab the Sea Glad. Okay. I'm going to grab the fabricator here. Of course, it's nighttime, so yeah, it doesn't go back up until day. So, we've got to go find the rest of the bioreactor pieces too, because that will continuously charge whether it's night or day. But, for now, let's make this. Okay. Alright. Weird. Sweet. That's weird. It's like half stuck through the wall. Well, I can't see it out here, though. Alright. So yeah, we're definitely gonna have to get a solar panel. Another solar panel going. I don't know if that will increase the total amount of power I can have, or if that just makes it go up faster during the daytime. I'm not sure. So, I will figure that one out off camera, and hopefully in the next episode we will go back down into that other biome and see if we can get the rest of the sea moth going, because the sea moth is an actual vessel where you're inside it and those critters can't come and get you, and it makes getting down to some of the deeper areas a lot more safe. So yeah, that's what we'll be up to next time. I will off camera get another solar panel going, And now that we've got this thing and the one at the other one, I should be able to get first aid kits rather quickly, two at a time. You know, that'll definitely help with getting attacked. And, yeah. So, till next time, as always, take it easy, have fun, later.